Yeah.
There you go.
Last meeting of...
Good afternoon. I'd like to call today's meeting to order. This is a special meeting of the East Kildonan Transcoda Community Committee. For all the people in attendance here today, I'd like to introduce the members of the committee. To the far end of the table, we have Councillor Jason Schreier from East Kildonan Elmwood. To his right, we have Councillor Russ Wyatt from Transcona. I'm Jeff Rawati. I'm the councillor for North Kildonan, and I'll be acting as our chair. We also have Andrew Poitras. He's a senior committee clerk and will be taking care of official business here today for the meeting. As this is a special meeting, only items that were previously published on the agenda will be considered today. I'd like to point out this is committee meeting number 20 since last of this council session since last September. And unless somebody holds a meeting before 11:59 p.m. tonight, we are the last group to have a meeting before summer break. So, hardest work on the meeting committee here for sure.
And we've had 20 meetings.
20 meetings in total of community committee.
Wow.
Regular and special since September. So,
we are the James Browns. We are the James Browns of community committee meetings.
How do you figure?
Hardest working community
There you go.
Self-proclaimed.
Their own lives. There you go.
Actually,
you can All right. So item number one is a land dedication reserve for Louise Page Park.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. What this is the budget was... this is a mini pocket park in West Transcona on Dowling Avenue West, 100 block. And it's pretty tired. It's pretty, not much has gone on there, been done there for quite a while. And so I received calls and I think even at one point a petition from residents wanting to do something with the park to clean it up. So there's an opportunity to do exactly that. This will be a what's called a pleasure park, and it's basically a passive park where there's not play equipment, because throughout Transcona we have, well, now with new developments we have about over 60 parks, but prior to that we had about 55-56 parks. So the problem is that you literally have one park around one block, and then literally a block and a half away you have another park. And both of these parks had playground equipment in them. Both of them had to be maintained. And so it's not required or necessary to have a playground at every block and a half. And so here's an example where a block and a half from this park is another park called Thomas Copeland, which has a lot of play equipment in it right now, playground and everything else. And so this is an opportunity to make Thomas Copeland will be the playground park,
right?
And this will be the passive park. We've done this in other parts of Transcona, phasing this in. We're going to have an open house in September to explain all of this and to show it to residents and get feedback, not just this park but other parks we're fixing up. And literally across Day Street, now it is across Day, but a block away from this park on the other direction is another playground at Arts Action. When that playground's very tired, and we're rebuilding that one in the coming year as well, which we already voted on as a committee. So these are the parks. So as you can see in the diagram, there's a lot more, a lot of trees that are gonna be done. There'll be an open play area, left open for play, and a sitting area with the benches where folks can sit and just kind of relax in quiet contemplation. So that's this is to top up the budget to get to where it needs to be. Louise Page is an individual who's she's for all her life has done stuff for seniors in Transcona. She volunteers and has worked to help seniors all her years. And she's an amazing woman, and she's done a lot of great work in the community. So it was an honor to be able to name this park after Louise. Louise Page, she's just a wonderful person. Very humble, never asked for anything, never wanted anything, but it was just nice to be able to recognize her. So this tops up the budget to make it happen. So I'll move that.
Very nice. It says here the estimated cost is $30,000, but the request is for $37,500.
The estimated cost of the project is the application lot. That's not correct.
If you look at application,
The application amount should be $19,272.
That's what I see from the history. Yeah. Okay. That could just be from the history.
The report's asking for $37,500.
Okay, there was money already earmarked to this. Total project cost $30,000. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
On the application first page, it seems like more than like a 10%, you know, or whatever the internal cost piece is, whatever.
Yeah, that's not right. Project cost is not $30,000. That's incorrect. I'll call the planners about it, or the park planner, and fill out the application form. Shauna Prosiak, or Ian Lake, her colleague, and I'll ask him this afternoon, because that's not, we've already approved funding for this. There's funding already in place. The funding is to, where was it here? Where did I see it?
It'd be in the history, though.
Yeah, I think it's in the history.
Scroll up.
No, right here. Okay, where did I see?
Decision.
Yeah, okay, here, thank you. So there you go.
So this was subject to a report back. So this report back, I guess, would include a request for that 19,000 and whatever additional funds. So
just under 20.
Yeah, so you even though you pre-approved 19,000, it's not like this is going to be 37.5 over that 19,000. I believe it's all bundled into that one final amount now that they're reporting back as
well. And you showed in your previous reports always that 19,272 was almost like on hold, but it was already deducted.
Yeah.
So
they'll deduct the difference.
Gotcha.
So
thank you.
You'll see.
Yeah. Thanks, Mr. Chairman, for that.
Okay. What's the current name of the park?
Well, the current name was Dowling Avenue. 100 block.
Okay, all it was showing Louise. Okay.
Yeah. We changed the name already.
Okay, I see that.
Dowling. Who would want to be associated with that name?
Nice.
Oh, Mr. Chairman, counselor for East Elm, what he's called on, and has a sense of humor.
So, has the playground equipment already been removed, or is this part of the budget?
I believe it's in the budget already, Mr. Chairman.
The old stuff is still there.
Yeah, there's like I think a slide and a swing and an old sandbox.
Now, we got an update for our budget, sir, didn't we? Plan dedication.
Oh, hey. So where is that, Mr. Chairman?
8:18 this morning. Right now, this pet park is pretty barren. Right?
Yeah, well,
there's nothing.
No. This will clean it up. There's wood bollards there now. It'll fix those bollards up. Give it a better appearance. Tree it. You know, put some trees in which are needed.
I really like it.
Yeah.
Councilor Shire, would you mind taking the chair for a moment?
Sure.
I'm going to suggest a friendly amendment that the exact same playground or the exact same setup be added to Kellis Park. Your park is 10,300 square feet. Oh, I can't.
This is a new business.
It's an amendment to a motion that's on the floor.
Friendly amendment.
A bit of a stretch. You're going to move this a motion for a different park for land dedication funding.
It's a friendly amendment.
Yeah, I think that's a bit of a...
His park is 10,300 square feet.
You're saying it's a different
Mine's
subject.
10,
different subject. This different is a land dedication.
You still have time to call a special meeting, though. Until 4:30 today.
Can he?
Absolutely.
I can leave until September, but I'll let the staff know that I'm looking to do one as well.
The passive park?
Yeah.
It's a good idea.
Yeah.
The key is to do... to show the community where the playgrounds are.
And we've already had that discussion. Actually a playground right by there on Summerfield.
Yeah.
Where I already publicly have told everybody that, in my Herald ads and stuff.
Good.
Just this, we've got one old metal slide.
Yeah, yeah. And they want you to replace it, of course. So,
I told them that we actually put a really good play structure in on Springfield.
Right.
Not Springfield, on Summerfield. New picnic stand area that actually is covered. It's more of a Transcona thing. It's really nice. We kept that and actually cleaned the other park up really well and explained to everybody that that's where the emphasis was going to go. And
good.
But the park is pretty ugly right now, and some of the immediate neighbors have complained that it's
pretty ugly.
I think cleaning up some trees and this particular setup here would be appropriate. But okay, I will leave it till September.
See, and by doing that in the long run, what you do is for your future, your future counselors.
Yeah.
For North Kelowna, you're ensuring in 20 years, or you know, it's basically helping to maintain the playground system because you're removing the liability that's there, right?
Right.
And so you're actually concentrating on playgrounds in centralized locations, which are still accessible, but you don't have to try to find money for you know, one that's only a block away. You know, so I think majority of people, vast majority of folks, understand that or appreciate that. I think so.
Yeah, totally. Okay, so
you're withdrawing your motion.
I'll withdraw my motion and I'll take the chair back.
There you go.
So motion to approve this park at 37.5. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carry. Number two, community incentive grant to Transcona Biz.
Yes. This is well. I shouldn't have closed that.
Eurofest 2016.
Scroll it down, I guess. Hey, is this just LDR on that email?
LDR, yeah.
Oh, there was no community center grant report?
No, they weren't able to send an update.
Oh.
But I did email to your balance from...
Oh, I'm sorry.
It was June 30th, and I just subtracted what you had approved at the other July meetings.
Yes.
So in my email here, I says it looks like your balance is... $33,545 and change.
Okay, so we have enough funds there to do this?
Yes.
Okay. So, yeah, this, Mr. Chairman, is the Transcona Biz has undertaken the project of putting up more murals in not only inside the business improvement zone,
okay,
but in other parts of Transcona where they're good enough to work with the community to put up murals. And it's really exciting because... the murals they're looking at doing are not just murals, but they're art. And so I'm not knocking murals done elsewhere or anything, that it's not art. But they're going to, I don't know if edgy would be the word, but it's going to be something that will attract visitors to the community to see. And mural artists, so there's a number of mural artists that have been... approached, many have been interviewed, and so the community, the Transcona Biz, Alex Morrison is the executive director. She really wants to get going on this, which was the kind of the why we had this meeting was so important in the first place, amongst the other items. But so this will make it happen, and it will really, this basically doubles the size of the program they wanted to do. They already had a program budget of approximately $20,000. And when we were meeting about it and talking about it, we wanted to really, there were so many locations that had been identified that we did not have funding for. And this will have a bit of a wow effect in terms of the community, in terms of seeing all these murals going up over the course of the next couple of months. So it's really exciting, and anyway, happy to support this.
Perfect.
For the full.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Moving on to item number three, Land Education Reserve, Good Neighbors Active Living Center. I understand Councillor Schreier is willing to participate in this particular project. Very popular with the Good Neighbors folks.
Oh, absolutely.
Let them not be blinded while they're playing their pickleball in the afternoon.
Right.
And good for socials, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a little bright in there during summer season socials, you know, until after 10 o'clock, so...
So are we going 50-50 on this?
I'd be thrilled.
Okay, myself as well.
So it's been moved by Councillor Shire. I'm very supportive. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Number four, topsoil return policy.
Yeah. Yes, Mr. Chairman. This I'm just going to read the whereases for those listening from home. Whereas presently developers, builders will strip and remove the topsoil from green field development prior to construction of roads and homes. And whereas topsoil is a valuable resource and a special commodity in that it has literally taken thousands of years to create the topsoil that sits above the prairie gumbo. And whereas much of the topsoil is then sold to topsoil landscape companies.
And whereas when individuals buy a lot, they are in fact buying a piece of land. And whereas the land should always include the soil that rested upon it. And whereas the practice presently is to require new homeowners to buy back the topsoil that had previously belonged to them. And whereas the said property owner must also purchase enough topsoil to landscape the city-owned property boulevard from the end of his or her property line to the front street. Therefore, be it resolved that the Standing Policy Committee on Property Development, Heritage, and Downtown Development be requested to direct the Winnipeg Public Service to, as part of its permit process, require verification in writing that the topsoil was returned to the new homeowner by the developer builder, or that a credit in lieu of the topsoil was provided to said homeowner. So this will be moved forward. The administration will pursue it. We'll look at it. And it's something which, I think folks, when they buy the land, they don't realize that previously resting on this land was 3 to 5 feet of topsoil. And they don't necessarily realize it, because by the time they buy the land, the topsoil is gone and has been scraped off. And so as someone who's bought a new home 10 years ago, what you're left with is basically prairie gumbo, which when hard is like concrete, and when dry is like concrete. And it's basically landscaped right up to against the facade or the base of your house, your foundation of your house, and landscaped appropriately as required by the lot grading bylaw of the city of Winnipeg to the front street, or in the case may be to the back lane, or both. And then you, as a homeowner, can either pay the builder, developer, to do the landscaping, or do it yourself. Either way, you're having to pay for the topsoil. And all I'm saying here is that the soil should come with the land. If you buy a farm, who could imagine the previous owner of a farm scraping off his topsoil and selling it and then giving you the title to the land as a farm? You know,
Councillor, if I may, it's called wind to soil erosion, or wind erosion.
Yeah, wind erosion. Yeah, yeah. Well, this is very true, and topsoil is really a precious commodity in the sense that it takes thousands of years to develop. There's been a lot of books written and studies done on exactly what Councillor Schreier just mentioned, which is topsoil erosion. A lot of programs outside of Winnipeg and in the countryside of the country to preserve topsoil. But here's an example where we have topsoil, but the property owner, the new property owner, is being denied that soil that belongs to them. So I don't think this would be that onerous of a process. It would just be another check in the box, if you like, in terms of the permit office saying, yeah, we have that form here, done. And we've now confirmed that your topsoil has been returned. Or a credit there in lieu of by the builder or developer. Thank you.
Perfect. Okay. Motion's been heard. Any further discussion?
Aye.
I think he's right there. All is imposed. Carried.
Thank you.
Number five, Councillor White, if you wouldn't mind grabbing the chair.
Yes.
Just to read it into the record, I'll read my whereases. Whereas mini roundabouts were installed in 2010 on Road Street to improve safety and flow for pedestrians, vehicles, and cyclists as part of an active transportation initiative, and whereas residents of the area have expressed concerns that collisions/near collisions have increased while pedestrian safety has decreased. Therefore, be it resolved that the Standing Policy Committee on Infrastructure Renewal and Public Works be requested to direct the Winnipeg Public Service to review the performance of the intersection at Road and Layton Avenue, including but not limited to driver and pedestrian real-world behaviors, and report back to the Standing Committee on whether any changes or improvements are warranted. The whole process of these mini roundabouts or traffic calming circles were kind of rushed in back in 2010. They had proposed a couple more further up Roach in my ward, but I kept those entirely out. It was pointed out to me, I actually had two sides of this particular circle. I knew it was on the boundary of my ward. I actually have one corner. and the one resident that I have that borders onto this has contacted me directly this morning, so I asked this item to be added on. I have heard from other members of the public. I'm not trying to bias this in any way. I just want to have our traffic engineers come back and make sure that they're performing as believed and as expected. I apologize I didn't come and talk to Jason ahead of time on this particular one, and just...
Well,
Go ahead, Councilor Shire.
Thank you, Councilor Shire.
No, go ahead, Councilor Shire.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you're the chair. Sorry.
That's okay. These things happen. I would. It was within the realm of what one could consider even. What I could add to is a friendly amendment. Not that there's anything for me to add, as a matter of fact, but it was in that realm of something that obviously I can live with. That's worthy. Councilor Rawati, you're not the only one that has heard complaints on this. So your idea of looking for a report back from the administration, that's fine with me. And thank you, because it's actually something that I can work with as well, that I can learn from. Then everybody that talks with me about this can learn from. And on that basis, I do feel obliged to take note of it, given that three quarters of the intersection in question is in my ward. Sure, I look forward to that report as well.
Okay, any other discussion? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. No other items? I'll pass the chair back to you, sir.
Thank you. Councillor Shire moves adjournment. All's in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Have a good summer, everyone, unless we're still meeting before midnight.
Oh, yeah, that's right. If there's any...
Is it
how
midnight?
How much time do you need to call a special meeting?
5 minutes.